In this video, we demonstrate the steps for doffing level C chemical personal protective equipment. After a decon team member has assisted in the process of chemical decontamination, their personal protective equipment must be taken off in a controlled step-by-step process. Prior to doffing the equipment, each decon team member will need to clean the outside of the suit by going through the decontamination process. Using soap, water, and scrub brushes, they should pay particular attention to areas of the PPE that were heavily soiled. Throughout the doffing process, ensure the respiratory system is protected by making sure the PAP or hood is one of the last items to be removed. PPE items removed that are not suitable for decontamination and reuse should be disposed of in a trash container. Begin by removing the patient care gloves that were worn on the outside of the outer protective gloves. The doffing partner should then remove the tape sealing the outer protective gloves to the suit. The outer protective gloves can then be removed and discarded. Next, remove the belt, ensuring the hood stays on. While the remaining items of the PPE are removed, the PAPR unit can either be placed on a chair or similar surface, or can be carried by the doffing partner until the hood is ready to be removed. The doffing partner should then open the exterior zipper seal, unzip the suit, and begin to remove the suit. Touch only the exterior surfaces as the suit is removed from the shoulders. Do not reach inside the suit at the shoulders when starting the removal process. Guide the suit down over the arms and the wrists. Once the decon member's top half is free of the suit, continue rolling down to knee level to prevent the suit arms from becoming uncontrolled. At this point, the decon team member can sit. The decon team member can assist in the removal of the suit, but they should try and touch only the inside portions of the suit with their inner gloves. Next, the tape at the top of the outer boots should be removed. Remove the outer boots and suit. These can be done individually or as one item. The suit should then be gathered up and discarded. Next, the hood can be removed from the head. The doffing partner should gather the outer shroud of the hood over the head of the decon team member. The decon team member can then push the hood upwards from within the inner shroud while the doffing partner moves it away. The hood, tubing, and papper are reusable items. The doffing partner should ensure this equipment is put aside for later decontamination. Next, the tape that is securing the inner boot liners can be removed. With the tape removed, the boot liners can be taken off and placed in the trash. Finally, the inner gloves can be removed using glove and glove technique. The decon team member should then wash their hands. After the doffing process is complete, the doffing partner should take and record vital signs, and the decon team member should hydrate with a decaffeinated beverage. The decon team member will then proceed to a personal shower and debriefing.